Dear students, I introduce one of the simple concept in inorganic chemistry, that is logarithmic contraction and its effects. What is actually logarithmic contraction? First of all, in logarithms, the logarithms actually appear from 6th period. 6th period onwards, you see the logarithms. The 6th period, this is the 6th period, cesium, barium, lanthanum to hafnium, these are what are lanthanides. So I have written here, 6th period means 6th shell. So I have written here 6 shells, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 shells. The configuration we talk about lanthanides, this is what 6 shell, 6s2, 5d1, 4f, 1 to 14, 4f, 1 to 14, that means in lanthanides, the differentiating electrons entering into the lanthanide, differentiating electron entering into f orbitals of antipenetrable shell, f orbitals of antipenetrable shell. As a result, the 14 units of nuclear charge increasing, 14 units of nuclear charge increasing, and in addition to this, the f orbitals are poor shielders. F orbitals are poor shielder. 14 units of nuclear charge increasing. In addition to this, F orbitals are poor shielders. Therefore, the 14 units of nuclear charge strongly working on this particular outermost orbital electron. As a result, the outermost orbital electron actually dragged towards the nucleus. As a result, now cerium to lutetium, gradually atomic size are decreasing. This decrease in atomic size is from cerium to lutetium, what we call lanthanide contraction. Next, this is the concept of lanthanide contraction. After taking this, what are the effects of lanthanide contraction? Let us see now. First one, while discussing d-block element, we used to say 3d to 4d atomic size are increasing, but 4d to 5d atomic size are decreasing or remaining same. Now we consider first effect, 3d to 4d sizes are increasing, but 4d to 5d atomic size are decreasing or remaining same. This is due to what? Lanthanide contraction. This is due to lanthanide contraction effect. But 3d to 4d atomic size are increasing, 4d to 5d it should increase, but not increasing, decreasing or remaining same. This is due to lanthanide contraction effect, first effect. Coming to the second one, once top to the bottom, 3d to 4d, 4d to 5d in a group, the densities are increasing. But that is the case, 3d to 4d, the density has to increase, and 4d to 5d, density has to normally increase. Yes, 3d to 4d increasing, 4d to 5d also normally density has to increase. But what we observe in this case, 3d to 4d, densities are increasing, but 4d to 5d, densities are abnormally increasing. Unexpectedly, abnormally increasing. This is due to again lanthanide contraction. But 3d to 4d normal increase in density, but 4d to 5d densities are abnormally increasing. This is due to again lanthanide contraction. So, decrease in atomic size of 5d series of elements and abnormal increase in the densities of 5d series of elements is due to what? Lanthanide contraction. Let's see, coming to the next point. Thallium, lead and bismuth. Thallium, lead and bismuth are actually exhibiting inert pair effect. I hope you know very well what is inert pair effect. In the case of 3rd, 4th and 5th year group, S electron pair is reluctant to participate in chemical bonding. That's what we call the inert pair effect. So thallium actually 3rd year group, this is lead is what 4th year group, this is what 5th year group. Their common oxygen number should be plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. But what I have written on the board, thallium is plus 1. Lead is plus 2, this is what plus 3. This is due to inert pair effect. The inert pair effect exhibited by thallium, lead and bismuth. Due to again lanthanide contraction. See, inert pair effect, lanthanide contraction. What is the relationship between these two? Let me show the electronic configuration of mercury amide. Mercury again, 6th period. I have written here 6 shells hydrogen.
This is the electronic configuration of mercury. Mercury, I am showing the configuration here. This is 6s2, 5d10, 4f14. 6s2, 5d10, 4f14. This is the outer electronic configuration of this particular mercury. Right? Now we are talking about thallium. Let us see what is actually happening up to mercury. So here, lanthanum to mercury talk about. Here, D1 to D10. See, 10 electrons. 10 electrons from lanthanum to mercury entering into what? D orbital penetration. D orbital penetration. As a result, nuclear charge increased by what? 10 units. Next. Here, cesium to rhodium. Here, cesium to rhodium. This is what again? 14 electrons here. Cesium to rhodium, the electrons are entering into what? F orbitals of anti-penetrative shell. As a result, once 14 electrons are entering into inner shell, anti-penetrative shell, again 14 more units of nuclear charge increasing. Come on, say, you can only say now, 24 units of nuclear charge increasing. Where to check it? See, lanthanum to mercury, 24 units of nuclear charge increasing. 24 units of nuclear charge increasing. As a result, what is happening? Nuclear charge increasing, and again, distance is not increasing. Moreover, fulfilled D and F orbitals are poor shielders. Poor shielder. Therefore, 24 units of nuclear charge is strongly working on this particular 6s orbital electron. The 24 units of nuclear charge is strongly working on this particular 6s orbital electrons. Therefore, 6th orbital electron is tightly held. It cannot easily involve in chemical bonding. As a result, what is the thallium configuration? Come on, 6s2, it is 6p1. Which one? Thallium. What is the configuration of lead? Come on, look the board. It is about 6p2. Come on, look the board. Bismarck. It is what actually 6p3. What I said, due to lanthanide, presence of lanthanide element, lanthanide contraction effect, nearly 24 units of nuclear charge is increasing. And because of this particular 6s orbital electron is tightly held, as a result, hardly thallium can lose one electron, 6p1. Lead can lose two electrons, 6p2. And bismuth hardly can lose only three electrons, 6p3. That means what? Thallium easily losing one electron, lead easily losing two electrons, and bismuth easily losing what? Three electrons. Therefore, they commonly exhibit plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, but they are not exhibiting the higher oxidation number equal to group number 3, 4, 5. They are not commonly exhibiting the group number of oxidation number, but they are exhibiting lower than the group number, that is plus 1, plus 2, and plus 3. This is due to what? Presence of lanthanide elements and the lanthanide contraction effect, the reason for exhibition of this inert trade effect by thallium, lead, and bismuth. Coming to the next point. What we said here only, 3D to 4D atomic size increasing, but 4D to 5D atomic size decreasing more or less same. So due to lanthanide contraction effect, recollect, the 4D and 5D elements are having more or less same sizes. 4D and 5D elements are having what? More or less same sizes. As a result, what is happening? The 4D and 5D elements are having more or less same size. Remember one point in the periodic table, any two elements having more or less same sizes, their properties are much more similar. Once you are seeing the 4D and 5D elements are having similar atomic sizes, their properties are same. Moreover, 4D and 5D elements are having the same mineral. Wherever 4D element is there, 5D element. Means what? Wherever zirconium, there hafnium. Wherever ruthenium, there hafnium, there osmium. Wherever silver, definitely you find some amount of iron. Wherever you find cadmium, there definitely mercury. Therefore, because of similar atomic sizes, their properties are similar. They are available in the same mineral. Therefore, I put like this boxes. So, wherever zirconium is there, there hafnium. Suppose wherever you find hafnium in a particular mineral, there definitely you find some zirconium. So, 4D and 5D elements are showing similarities and also available in the same mineral in the same place because of this particular lanthanide contraction effect. Next, coming to the next one. Due to lanthanide contraction effect, this particular yttrium atomic size is comparable to lanthanide. Yttrium atomic size is comparable to lanthanide. For the following, now scandium to yttrium atomic size increasing and yttrium to lanthanum atomic size increasing. So on this particular third B group, the lanthanide contraction effect is not there. Third B group only. Next, here after lanthanum, what are the elements? Lanthanide. In lanthanide, there is lanthanide contraction effect. There is a decrease in the atomic size. Therefore, The atrium anomic size is comparable to lanthanides. So following 3D to 4D size increasing, but 4D to 5D size increasing. Next, cerium to lutetium lanthanide, because of lanthanide contraction, there is a gradual decrease in size. Therefore, yttrium atomic size is comparable to lanthanide. Therefore, yttrium is showing much more similarity to lanthanide. Yttrium atomic size is comparable to lanthanide because of lanthanide contraction effect. Therefore, yttrium is showing similarities with the lanthanide elements. Next, coming to this one. Because of lanthanide contraction effect, don't feel that there is a large decrease in size. No, size decreases, there we agree. But one element to other element, size decreases little. Among the lanthanides, the size decreases little. Therefore, separation of lanthanides from one element to other element is difficult. Lanthanides contraction with the, but one element to other element, lanthanide contraction with the, and one element to other element, there is no much difference in the size. Size difference with the, but little. Therefore, one size difference is little, therefore it is difficult to separate lanthanides from one element to other element. Coming to next one. What we said, yttrium is actually having comparable atomic size with lanthanide. Comparable atomic size with lanthanide. The yttrium is showing more similarity with the lanthanide size. There actually yttrium is fitting in between the lanthanide. See, in between holmium and erbium. In between holmium and erbium, this yttrium is perfectly fitting in between holmium and erbium. So size is 0.909 and again 0.9, 0.89. Little different. Yttrium is correctly fitting in between holmium and erbium. Next, coming to next point, all the things were perfectly discussed about this particular lanthanide contraction and its effects, we agree. But one point is important, in the gradual decrease in atomic sizes to take, this europium and ytterbium, remember, in europium and again ytterbium, europium and ytterbium, there is a deviation. So the gradual cerium to cerium, praseodymium, neodymium, promethium, samarium, europium. So up to samarium atomic size is decreasing. Up to samarium atomic size is decreasing, but at europium size is increasing. Again decreasing samarium, europium, gadolinium to again ytterbium, gadolinium, terbium, dysprosium, holmium, erbium, thulium. Up to thulium atomic size is decreasing, and again ytterbium atomic size is increasing. Means what? So the gradual decrease in atomic sizes according to lanthanide contraction effect. Gradual decrease in atomic sizes is not followed by this particular europium and ytterbium. Europium and ytterbium deviating from the gradual decrease in atomic sizes. Gradual decrease in atomic sizes. This is also one of the points to remember. So this particular europium and ytterbium are not following gradual decrease in atomic sizes. One more point what I will mention is, look here. In third group means what is wrong? Scandium, yttrium, lanthanum. Scandium, yttrium, and lanthanum, they are not following lanthanide contraction. There is no effect of lanthanide contraction in their properties. As you take IP values, you take atomic sizes, this particular three elements at what third B group, scandium, yttrium, and lanthanum, they are not following this lanthanide contraction effect. Means what? There is no lanthanide contraction effect on the properties of this particular third B group, scandium, yttrium, and lanthanum. This is the brief discussion about lanthanide contraction and again its effects. Each and every point is very, very important.